Today, we'll cover every list method in Python. The list append method in Python adds an element to the end of the list. Let's make ourselves a list A that holds the elements 1, 2, and 3. If we call append on A and add on the element 4, you'll get no output. If you look at A, you will see that 4 was added to the end of the list. From what we just went through, hopefully you caught the important thing. If you were to do a line like A equals A dot append 5, you would not get your desired result. Since append returns none, you would make A equal none, and then you completely lost your existing list. Here's another thing to consider. If we go back a few steps, and A now equals the list containing 1, 2, and 3, then we append the list containing 4, 5, and 6. What will A look like after writing this line of code? Well, it does not add the elements in the new list individually. It adds the whole list as a single item. So A is now the list containing 1, 2, 3, and the list containing 4, 5, and 6. The list clear method in Python clears the list. Let's give ourselves a list A that holds the elements 1, 2, and 3. If you call clear on A, the list will now be empty. There's a potential error you can trigger with clear. Let's go back to where A contains 1 through 3. If you wrote the clear line as A equals A dot clear, you would lose your list as the clear function returns none. It does not return the new list. Also, there's no special error message for trying to clear an already empty list, so do not write any code depending on that kind of functionality. The list copy method returns a shallow copy of a list in Python. Just a front-loaded warning right now. This is more of an intermediate level video, so if you're not familiar with memory addresses and pointers in programming, this video is not for you. Let's give ourselves a list A that holds the elements 1, 2, and 3. After that, if we write the line B equals A, what that line means is store in the variable B the memory address of A. If we then did B index 0 equals 5, then looked at A, you would see that A changed, even though it seems like we didn't change A at all, but we did. When we changed B, we were actually just operating on memory shared between A and B, so changing B changed A. The reverse would be true as well. I'll give you what is a bit of a confusing example first. If we again did A equals the list containing 1, 2, and 3, then did that B equals A dot copy, we would be saying that in B is a shallow copy of the list A. When we do B index 0 equals 5, then look at A, A is unchanged. This is because B is now not sharing memory with A. B has a list of the memory addresses of the three integers, and A has the same list of the memory addresses of the three integers, but in a different place in memory. So changing B does not change A. But now for the seemingly confusing part, I led in with the fact that the copy method returns a shallow copy. What gives then? This copy seems pretty deep to me, and like we've gotten around the shared memory problem from the first example. I'm getting to that. For our next example, A is the list containing 1. So, a nested list. Meaning what is at A's memory address is the address at which the list containing 1 is stored. For our next step, if we did B equals A.copy, B would have its own memory address, but the information at that memory address would still be the address at which the same list from A is being stored. So because of a double pointer of sorts, you are back to the first example of shared memory and changing A, also changing B. If you want to solve this issue, from copy, import deep copy. But this is not a video about deep copy, so that is all I will say on deep copy in this video. The count list method in Python counts the number of occurrences of a specified object in a list. Let's give ourselves a list A that holds the elements 1, 2, and 2. If we want to see how many 2s are in A, we would just write A.count2. Since there are 2 2s in A, count would return 2. No funny business or gotchas here, just simple counting. In Python, the listExtend method extends a list by adding items from a structure that can be looped over. Here's the most basic example. If we give ourselves a list A that holds 1, 2, and 3, then do A.extend and pass in a list that holds 4, 5, and 6, then the list A will now hold 1 through 6. Now to expand on what I said at the start of the video, what are the structures that can be looped over in Python? Those are lists, tuples, sets, dictionaries, and strings. Those are your main ones at least. Lists, tuples, and sets give you no funny business when passing them into extend. Extend just puts the elements inside the structure you passed in into your existing list. If you pass a dictionary into extend, so A equals the list containing 1 through 3, then if you do A.extend with the dictionary containing the string containing A mapped to 1, A will only have the key from the dictionary added into it, not the whole key value pair. Back to A equaling the list containing 1 through 3, if you do A.extend with the string ABC, the list will now contain 1 through 3 and the strings A through C. This is because a string is itself something that can be looped over, so extend adds each and every character from the string. The listIndex method in Python returns the numeric location of an element in the list. Let's give ourselves a list A that holds the elements 1, 2, and 3. If you call index on A and look for the element 1, it will return 0. The way to read this return value is that the element 1 is at index 0. There is a potential error you can trigger when working with the index method. Let's try to see the index of the element 4, an element that clearly does not exist in this list. So if we call index on A with our argument being 4, then we will get a value error that 4 is not in the list. The insert list method in Python inserts a given element into the list at a given index. We have a list A that contains 1, 2, and 3. If we do A.insert 0, negative 1, then we've inserted the value negative 1 at the start of the list at index 0. If we do A.insert 4, then 4 gets inserted at the end of the list. Finally, if we do A.insert 2, 1.5, then 1.5 gets inserted at index 2. Everything originally at index 0 through 1 gets pushed to the left, and everything at index 2 to the end of the list gets pushed to the right. The list pop method in Python removes an element from the list. Let's give ourselves a list A that holds the elements 1, 2, and 3. If we just call pop on A, you'll see the next line of output is 3. If you print out A, you'll see that A now only contains 1 and 2. We've learned two important things here. First, pop's default behavior is to remove the last item from the list. Also, though the pop method returns the item that it removes, let's back up a bit and make A our original list. If, instead of just calling pop on A, we set A equal to the output of calling pop on A, we would then completely lose our list in memory, as A would only hold the value that pop just removed. There are two potential errors you can trigger when working with the pop method. Let's make A an empty list. If A is an empty list and we try to call pop on it, then we will get an index error that we are trying to pop from an empty list. And the simple solution to this error is, if the list is empty, don't pop from it. The other error you can trigger is a nice segue into the other functionality of pop. You can pass an index into the pop function. Say, for example, A is the list containing 1 and 2. If we passed in the index 2 to pop, we would get an index error, pop index out of range. So you cannot pop items from a list that evidently doesn't exist. Going back to A being a list containing 1, 2, and 3, if we called pop of 0 on this list, the number 1 would get returned, and the first element would be removed from the list. So, if you pass an index that exists within the Python list, pop will remove the item at that particular index. Be warned, though, popping in any item that's not the last item can be a time-consuming operation as your lists grow larger and larger in Python. The remove list method in Python removes the first occurrence of a specific element from a list. We have a list A that contains 1, 2, 2, and 3. If we do A.remove2, the first 2 gets removed, and the list now contains 1 through 3. If we were to then do A.remove4, we would get a value error because the element 4 is not in the list. To avoid this value error, you must make sure that every element you pass into remove actually exists in the list. The list reverse method in Python reverses the list in place. Let's check out what that means. If you had a list A with the elements 3, then 2, then 1 in it, then called reverse on it, A would be modified to now be in the order of 1, then 2, then 3. The in place part means that no extra memory was used to do the reversing. This is in direct contrast to the reversed function in Python. Reversed returns an iterator object. There is a takeaway from all of this. If you care about the list itself being reversed and then want to do further operations on the list, then use the list reverse method. If, however, all you want to achieve is looping through the elements once they are reversed, then use the reversed function. The list sort method in Python sorts a list in place. Let's check out what that means. If you had a list A with the elements 3, then 2, then 1 in it, then called sort on it, A would be modified to now be in the order of 1 through 3. The in place part means, if you did not catch it already, the sorting does not make a new list. The list A itself is modified, unlike the built-in sorted function that makes an entirely new list. Let's shuffle up the list A a little bit and make it be in the order of 1, 3, 2. If you wanted the list to be descending instead of ascending, you could specify the keyword argument of reverse in the sort function to be true. That would put A in the order of 3 through 1. We are not yet done with the functionality of sort. You can also specify different functions to make sure your list gets sorted in a certain way. Let's now make the list A hold Brittany, Charlie, Alf. If we wanted to sort this list by length of names, we could call the sort method and specify the keyword argument key in the sort function to be len. That will sort the list to be in the order of Alf, Charlie, Brittany, or sorted in ascending order of name length. Staying on Alf, Brittany, Charlie, let's change the list up a little bit. We will lowercase the start of Alf and Brittany's names. If you try to just call the sort method from here, Charlie will end up at the front. Default word sorting in Python works on characters' ASCII values. To make a long description short, ASCII is a system that maps letters to numbers. It just so happens that uppercase letters have a lower number than lowercase letters, hence why Charlie ends up at the front in this. If we called the list sort method again, but made the key be str.lower, this would sort all the names as if every name was completely lowercase. This would get the proper order once again of Alf, Brittany, Charlie. This has been Jakubication.
Like and subscribe to learn more.